As long as you were born and bred in Nigeria, you are a Nigerian. As long as you carried a Nigerian passport, you are a Nigerian. Stop deceiving yourself. Fellow Nigerians, on behalf of the Global Coalition for Security and Democracy in Nigeria, we wish to salute Senator Eninaya Abaribe, representing Abia South Senatorial District in the Nigerian Senate. We salute him for courageously standing up and asking Head of State, retired Major General Muhammadu Buhari, to resign from office. That call is long overdue. Any leader that cannot provide security and welfare, which forms the cornerstone of the Nigerian Constitution, does not need to spend one more day in office. It is no longer news that Muhammadu Buhari has lost control in steering the ship of state. He is in office, but is not in power. His wife Aisha told us previously that her husband is not in office because Nigeria is being ruled by two persons. At the Global Coalition for Security and Democracy in Nigeria, we don't play politics with Nigeria. It's our country. So this is not about APC, PDP talk. I'm not standing here to speak for any political party. In fact, we cannot take leadership from PDP that has been there for 16 years, give it to APC, who totally messed up the system. They will take the power and take it back to APC. No, will not return to our vomit. Nigerians should be ready for a fresh country come 2023. We have swallowed enough, and enough is really enough. Now, spokesperson to Muhammadu Buhari said that the call by Abaribe is foolish. He used the word foolish. According to him, Abaribe was the one that signed Shoti for Nnamdi Kanu. Therefore, he should not be talking, that he should be in jail. But the fact is that Abaribe and others, they dropped money for that, for signing that Shoti. They dropped money. So as long as that money was not refunded to them, they have no right to intimidate him with that case so that he does not speak. So because Shehu Garba used the word foolish, I'm going to use the word foolish here also, severally. It is foolish to allow Muhammadu Buhari to continue to be the president, head of state, later retired major general, steering the ship of state aground. To be foolish to allow that. It is foolish to attempt to intimidate other legislators so that they don't speak up. It is foolish to think that Nigerians do not support Abaribe. We fully support him. He has spoken the mind of more than 80% of Nigerians. Anyway, Shehu Garba is working for his Naira and Kobo. He has to speak. But Aisha Buhari was the one that asked Jonathan Goodluck to resign because of the insecurity going on in Nigeria at that time. Now, it is time for Aisha Buhari to tell her husband to resign. The time has come for her to tell her husband to resign. Because it is clear that even the blind can see that this manner of Buhari has nothing to offer. Aisha Buhari, tell your husband to resign because the security situation in Nigeria has worsened far more than how he met it. Under a retired army general, no military strategy. If legislators are afraid to speak now in the name of loyalty, you are exposing yourselves and your families to worsening insecurity. Speak and act now for us all to be safe, or be silent for us all to die. Abaribe has spoken the mind of more than 80% of Nigerians living at home and abroad. And I am standing here to speak on behalf of this coalition that we support that Muhammadu Buhari should go and rest. He desperately wanted to be in office, overthrew a democratically elected government, struggled for 12 years to be president. We thought that he had something to offer. He has nothing, absolutely nothing to offer. We support the call for his resignation. Nigeria is bigger than 100 Buhari put together. Nigerian politicians and senators should not stop there. Go ahead, before you even remove Buhari, remove him as petroleum minister. He has not been able to fulfill his manifesto agenda even as a president. He has added another portfolio when he has no capacity to perform. We are losing billions of naira through the NNPC because senators are silent. They keep silent because they feel that when they talk, they'll be intimidated or something like that. How do you run a Senate like that? How do you run a government like that? Reduce your salary. That is another thing you have to do now. Then, of course, remove Buhari as minister for petroleum because he does not have the managerial acumen to occupy that position. In terms of security, the southern borders were closed, but some of the northern borders were open. So terrorism and smuggling was entering into Nigeria from that part of the country. In November 2019, House of Reps member, who coincidentally is a nephew to Muhammadu Buhari, said that the border in Daura, Katsina State, Buhari's hometown, was open. So terrorists could come in, smuggling could come in, and that is part of the insecurity we're experiencing today as a people. It took 3 years for the federal government of Nigeria to fight and put an end to the Nigerian Civil War that started in 1967, when ammunitions were less sophisticated. Today, in this modern world, we have more sophisticated weapons, but it is quite disheartening that for 17 years, despite the huge budget for our defense, this government and previous governments have not been able to defeat Boko Haram for 17 years. But you were able to end the civil war under 3 years. Why? Because some persons are commercializing terrorism and they are feeding fat on the blood of Nigerians. Lai Mohammed, Information Minister, lied severally. And he says it with so much conviction that Boko Haram has been technically defeated. Recently, the same Lai Mohammed lied during an international interview that there is nothing like the anti-social media bill at the National Assembly. He said it authoritatively and categorically. At his age, he could lie so blatantly. So any government that is built on falsehood will not take us anywhere. Our legislators monitor the impeachment proceedings of Donald Trump on TV, but they forget the fact, or they ignore the fact, that the issues we have in Nigeria is worse than what is going on in the United States of America. The impeachment against Donald Trump, the proceedings is all about foreign intervention and all that. But during our 2019 sham election, APC imported people from Niger Republic to openly campaign for their political party. Many foreigners were imported to vote in our election. The Nigerian immigration arrested over 300 persons for possessing the voters' card. They were all released. Why? Because their sponsors are from the top. Now, in appreciation to the support that the people of Niger Republic gave to Muhammadu's election, in the 2020 budget, there's a provision to construct a railway from Daura, from Katsina State, straight to Niger Republic, deep into Niger Republic, with our resources. On what grounds? A country that is borrowing to finance our entire budget. And the senators are quiet. He's doing that to appreciate them for the support they gave to him. Muhammadu Buhari technically signaled Boko Haram to go into hiding by announcing that the Nigerian Air Force has been ordered to attack them. Which military strategy does that if they have no hidden agenda? With the sorry state of Nigeria today, will Shehu Garba foolishly employ somebody like Muhammadu Buhari as a manager in his private company? The political party, known as the All Progressives Congress, is a terrorist organization from the top level. Many members of that party, they do not even know what is going on. It is quite disheartening that some Igbos in Nigeria, known as the Igbo in Nigerian movement, they have asked Abaribe, Senator Abaribe, to apologize and to resign for speaking the truth. What arrant nonsense. It was also from amongst the Igbo that Peter Obi was criticized. Atiku was criticized for picking Peter Obi as his running mate in the 2019 election from within the same Igbo. You want your own country in Biafra, in the name of Biafra, you have the right to agitate. We don't argue that. But you need to show more love and cooperation from amongst yourself, because you cannot give what you don't have. Why should the Igbo not be always criticizing themselves? We support Abaribe 247 because he has spoken the truth, and this is what everybody knows. Even Shehu Garba is just working for his money. He knows the truth that Nigeria is not secured. Everybody knows the truth. There's bloodletting everywhere. Muhammadu Buhari must resign. In my next video, I am going to read to you a letter which we are sending to the international community. The United Kingdom, United States of America, United Nations, to officially declare this party known as APC as a terrorist organization and to call them to do something urgently to secure our country, because we are all members of the United Nations. I assure you once again, fellow Nigerians, that all these things we are experiencing today, they will all pass away. And the wicked people that have been sponsoring this, the merchants of terrorism, all of them, they will wash away with our problems. God bless the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Thank you.